Hi, I'm Connie Henry from the K-12 Mathematics Office at Boston Public Schools. Today I'd like to introduce you to SPLAT, a highly engaging mathematical routine, and give you a quick overview about how it works. SPLAT was created by Steve Wyborny. You can go to his blog at www.stevewyborny.com to download the files. On his site, you will find the original SPLAT series, as well as fractions and nested splats. Many of the downloadables can be used with Microsoft's PowerPoint application and Google Slides. If you don't have Microsoft Office on your L4L, check out our tech tip video about your options for using Office and how you can download the Office suite. So what is SPLAT? SPLAT is a classroom routine that supports students to reason about number and to discuss and justify their thinking. It uses visual representations and asks probing questions about how numbers can be composed and decomposed. SPLAT provides challenges for students in the elementary grades, beginning with kindergarten through the secondary grades. Each actual SPLAT represents an unknown quantity. Let's take a look at a couple of examples. SPLAT includes 50 downloadables and are broken up into 10 levels. Let's take a quick look at level 2, which uses numbers 12 through 20. In lesson 2.2, students are first shown 17 blue dots. As you advance to the next slide, SPLAT, some dots are covered up. 8 dots are still shown, and others are now hidden. Students are then given an opportunity to solve for the unknown and to discuss their ideas. As you advance to the next slide, the answer is revealed, in this case, 9. These slides help highlight the relationship between the operations of addition and subtraction. Let's take a look at a quick example from lesson 5.1. Here we see 10 blue dots. Splat. 2 different color splats appear. Each color represents a different unknown quantity. The problem is now more complex as students try to figure out what 2 different quantities plus 3 equal 10. What are some ways students might solve for that equation? During the first reveal, students see that one of the unknowns is 3 dots. Now they have more information to solve for the other splat. During the next reveal, we see that 3 plus 4 plus 3 equal 10. What might they learn from the picture? How might they better understand the idea of variables within a simple equation? Let's take a quick look at lesson 11.1, in which fractions are introduced. Here we see the number 4 shown as 3 whole blue dots and 4 one-fourths shown in red. After the splat covers some of the total, we only see 2 whole dots and 1/4 of a dot. Students must use what they know to solve for what is under the splat. The visual representation of 2 and 1/4 helps guide them to find the missing add-in. During the reveal, they can also revise and discuss their thinking as needed. As they experience different splats from this series, they can deepen their understanding of working with whole numbers and fractions. Let's take a look at SPLAT in action.
I think I heard a lot of people saying the same number, so on the count of 3, let's say it, not scream it though. 1, 2, 3.
9!
Not talking to your neighbor just yet, okay? I want you to first think to yourself how many dots the SPLAT is covering.
4?
3.
3.
Who picked 3 that could tell me why it might be 3 that the splat is covering?
You
know what you just did without even realizing it? You were doing subtraction.
What's subtraction?
Subtraction is when, that's going to be our next math unit. Subtraction is when you take away. So she said, how many dots were there?
Nine.
Nine.
Because it's over there.
Take away how many? How many does black take away?
Three.
Equals?
Six. I'm correct.
Splat helps students to think algebraically and develop fluency with number combinations. The lessons are fun and engaging, and they are free to download. Give Splat a try in your math classroom. Thanks for watching.